Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting SQL interview question. So the question is, you have three tables, table A, table B and table C, and you need to join those three tables and filter the results to show only records that exist in exactly two of the tables. That means, so if you see here, in all these three tables you have some entries. And the output should be such that the entries which are common only in either of the two tables should be shown. That means here, if you see ID 2 and value A is common value. This particular row is present in both table A and table B. And 3 and common value is present in table B and table C. So that's why these two rows are there. But if you see this, 3 and unique A, even though the ID is 3, 3 is present in both the tables, but unique A is not present in table B or table C. So that's why only these two rows should be coming. So hope you understood the question. So now let's see how to solve this using SQL. So these are the three tables as we have discussed, and I have also inserted the values. So now what we'll do is, first I'll write select from table A cross full join. So what I will do, I'll do a full join on all the three tables together, and let's see what's the output there. Full join table C and on A dot ID is equal to B dot ID, and A dot value A is equal to B dot value B. On A dot ID is equal to B dot, sorry, C dot ID, and A dot value A is equal to C dot value C. And again, full join table BB on C dot ID is equal to BB dot ID, and C dot value C is equal to BB dot value B. So what I've done, first I've joined table A and B, and I made sure that A and B entries are same, and then on table C and made sure A and C entries are same, and then again with table B to make sure that B and C entries are same. So now let's see what's the output. So this is the output. Full join has happened on all the rows, and so what we'll do, we'll get only the required ID and value A. Okay, so what I'll do, so coalesce, so we all know what coalesce does. Coalesce A dot ID comma B dot ID comma C dot ID comma BB dot ID. Okay, so what this will do as ID, so coalesce, what it will do here, suppose if A dot ID is not null, then A dot ID will be considered. If A dot ID is null, then B dot ID will be considered, and if B dot ID is also null, then C dot ID will be considered. If C dot ID is also null, then BB dot ID will be considered. So in this way, in a single, in two columns for ID and value, we'll get all the required ID and values present in all the three tables. So basically what I'm trying to do is, so all the distinct values present in all these three tables, I'm trying to bring it in a single table, and comma coalesce of A dot value A comma B dot value B comma C dot value C comma BB dot value B as value comma so case when suppose what I'll do, suppose if the ID is present in if the entry is present in this particular row, in the table A, then I'll create three columns in table A, in table B and in table C. Okay, so what I'll do, so when case when A dot ID is not null, then 1, else 0, and as this column name, then 1, else 0, and as table A. And similarly, I'll copy this for table B and table C, and here if it is B dot ID, and here if it is C dot ID. Okay, so now if I run this together, what I'll get? Let's see. So what you are getting? So all the distinct entries and all the tables, and with values in table A, table B, and table C. So as discussed, we require only 2, common value and 3, common value. But if you see 5, common values present in all the three tables, we do not want that, because we want only the records which exist exactly in two of the tables. So if you see 5 common value, it is 1, 1, 1, right? And 2 common value is 1 in table A and 1 in table B, and 3 common value is 1 in table B and 0 in table C. And also here 3 common values, 0 in table B and 1 in table C. So what I'll do, I'll use a distinct here, and I'll keep this in a CT with CT as, and next select from CT ID, comma value, comma sum of in table A plus in table B plus in table C. For timing, let's do an order by 1, 2. So when I'm doing this order by 1, 2, so if you see here, 1 common value is present only in one table, so this should be gone, and 2 common value, you are getting 0, 0, 0, and you are getting 1, 1, 1. So when you do the sum of table A plus table B plus table C, these two will be merged into one row, and table A will become 1, and table B will become 1, and in table C will become 0. And similarly for 3 common value, when you sum these two rows, you'll get 0, 1, and 1. Okay. So now what I will do from CTE, so group by ID, comma value. So once I do this group by, this is what I'll get. So group by ID, comma value. Okay, I think we have to remove this order by. Group by ID, comma value. So I want only 2 common value and 3 in common value. That means I have to apply this filter. For this particular window, for this aggregate function, I have to apply this filter is equal to 2. So how to do that? We have to use the having clause. Since it's an aggregate function, we have to filter out this value using having clause is equal to 2. This is not required, because we want only an ID and value is the output. So if I do this, we'll get 2 common value and 3 common value. So hope you all understood the solution. So first you need to do a full join between A, B, and C to understand what is present in where, and do these calculations, and once you create this flag, you do the sum. So this is one solution using joins. And second solution, even though in the question they asked to join 3 tables and filter the results, so what one more solution is using unions. Okay, so that is also similar only. So what I'll do, select ID, comma value, A, comma A as source, and I'll keep this as value, A as source from table A. And if I run this, what am I getting? For table A, I'm creating a new column called source to make sure that this is coming from table A. And I'll do a union all. So why am I doing a union all and not a union? Because anyway, I know there won't be any distinct rows between these two data sets, because we have added one more column as A source, and for all the rows in the table A data set, the source value is A, and for all the rows in the table B data set, the source value is B. So definitely there will not be any common rows. And then union all table C, and here it is C. So once I run this, this is what I get. So what I'll do now, I'll keep this in a CTE with CTE, and select from CTE. Here it is ID, comma value, ID, comma value, comma count of distinct source. So we need to make sure that this particular ID and value exists only in two tables. So that means the count of distinct source should be 2. So let's run this and see what we are getting. So if you see 2 and common value and 3 and common value, the distinct counts of source is 2, whereas 5 and common value, the distinct count of source is 3. So we have to ignore all this. We have to filter out only these two. So again, as done earlier, we have to use the having clause. Having count of distinct source is equal to 2. And you can remove this. So once you run this, you'll get this same output. So this is the second way using unions. But since the question is asked to use the joins, Specifically, so we have to go with this approach, but ideally this will be the more easier approach to do. Okay, so hope you all understood the solution, both the solutions, and hope you all liked it. So if you like this content, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.